Hi everybody, proposed homeopathic outcome for COVID-19, and we have already know it is very much well known to all of us that government is taking emergent decisions regarding COVID-19, regarding application of homeopathic medicines and Ayush system of medicines to COVID-19 treatment. And yes, mankind is truly passing through a very tough time because of this COVID infection. I pray to the Almighty that He may imbibe us with the power that we can win this battle. Now, in this situation, a conflict arose between different levels of the government of India. Once the Central Council of Research in Homeopathy announced that arsenic album 30th potency in specific dose can reduce, can be useful as preventive to this infection. Subsequently, an order the first minister, government of India, they said that, or better to say, they directed that making any propaganda claiming homeopathic medicines or Ayush system of medicines can cure this infection, this is restricted and punishable. And now there is another U-turn which came very recently through the Twitter and Facebook accounts of the Ayush minister, Sripad Yasho Naik. And he said that in Goa, they are going to introduce the Ayush system of medicines for COVID-19 treatment, along with the Orthodox School of Medicines. So actually, here comes the utility of today's topic, especially when the government bodies and the ministries are getting divergent views. They cannot unite for the cause of homeopathy and definitely for the cause of mankind, for the sake of mankind. And now, in this particular situation, an unofficial unified platform, a common platform, is highly required. Now, moving to my next slide, what will be the outcome of this discussion? At the end of this discussion, what will we find? That common unified platform is the need of the day. Definitely, this is the need of the day. But this is not only true with the scenario which is running on now, but this was the need of the day since very long. And for that purpose, the unified platforms all over the world, even all over the India, that has emerged out, and still, even in these days, these platforms are very much necessary. A political platform is the only solution. I will try to divide my speech in two parts. Firstly, a common unified platform is required. And second portion is that that platform must be apolitical. I will show evidences from history that whenever there was political interference between the platforms for homeopathy, that has done bad and not good. And thirdly, history shows how such unified political platforms were proved to be beneficial for homeopathy. And during the course of my discussion, I will discuss about it in detail, how even the largest and most, I would like to repeat, the largest and most widely accepted international level homeopathic organization like LIGA, that was in 1976. I will discuss later on, and I think that will clear up your confusions. Now, what are the problems with government bodies? We all know that there are several government bodies. It was existing prior to the emerging of any unified organization, and even now, these organizations are there. But still, the problems with government bodies remains the same. The bureaucrats are mostly innocent about the principles of homeopathy. And not only that, they are rather most likely to be biased and guided by the traditional ideas about the medicines, even for longer time. So the revenue that is earned by pharma companies is definitely cannot be fulfilled by the homeopathic companies, because we prescribe less, as has already been discussed in detail by Dr. Agarwal. So we need to prescribe in minimum quantity, if I'm not going for the quality, but minimum quantity, and that can act even for longer time. So definitely, they're going to contribute a huge amount of revenue that the orthodox pharma companies can generate. Next point is councils or boards are not exclusively homeopaths. Yes, there is no tangible reasons behind this, why these bodies are not exclusively formed by the doctors of respective systems. Administrative bodies, especially which govern the system in the respective state or even throughout the country, they are not fully constructed within the system. and administrative councils, administrative bodies, councils, boards and whatnot. Everywhere there is invasion of either some political figure or some un-homeopathic persons who will definitely not go into the intricacies of homeopathy. It is not possible for him to understand. Now coming to a very important point, that government bodies cannot be a forum for setting up difference of opinions amongst few homeopathic representatives. Few homeopathic representatives representing these bodies may always have some divergent views. Even government is having divergent views as far as COVID-19 treatment is concerned. So this is very common. So the government bodies cannot be a forum for setting differences which we are talking. And definitely, these official bodies cannot be a forum for setting up all the differences. Definitely, that will not be a good message to society for homeopathy. And also, the different government bodies are having divergent views as far as the applicability of treatment that I have said just now. So, these print and telemedias will highlight this, and that will in turn cause a bad for homeopathy. Now, actually, these discussions, in my opinion, should take place, and difference of opinion must be settled inside our own camp. And here comes the practicability of this unofficial common unified platform. A platform is required to settle the controversies. And only after that, the representatives who are emerging out of that platform can speak and fight as one unified single body, and they can represent the entire decision of the body. I will show in later slides how these kind of resolutions arising out of such a unified common platform imposed and pressurized the Liga to withdraw their prevalent decisions, and how that acted well for homeopathy. And now, especially in this situation where government was not willing to introduce Ayush system of medicines, two largest organizations of India, namely the Homeopathic Medical Association of India, the HOMAI, and the Institution of Homeopaths of Kerala, IHK, they came forward and submitted a letter with three subsequent reminders to PMO, to the Honorable Prime Minister, claiming to have scientific research in the home. And who knows, that the other side can be even more brighter, that can be even more beneficial for the mankind. The homeopathic brethren may fight in home, but not in public, what I was just discussing. And if we have any claim on ordinary human faculty of reason and honesty, we submit to the most reasonable and realistic viewpoint and come out of our home unified. If we can show solidarity, we will win. All united we stand, and divided we fall. Now, recently, few homeopaths were searching for bridge courses, and they were misguided that if they can pursue this course, jobs are assured. So, this kind of divided rules are always going to be played between our system to turn us down. And now, here, this is definitely harmful for homeopathy. And here, specially comes the role of a unified platform, which can raise its voice and can reach the unified voice to the government authority and can turn their futile decisions into a perfect one, which will not only do good for the existence and development of homeopathy, but also will do good for the mankind. The tail may be different, but the crow doesn't become a peacock with the tails. Definitely, some of the isolated times may carry some favor with the authority today and some other tomorrow, but the whole cause of homeopathy can be served in this way. A democratic platform of homeopathy allow to place a debate with difference of opinion, and majority's decision will emerge out, which will definitely project the strongest voice in favor of homeopathy. This is the problem with the political organizations. Now, the political organizations, I will say that there is a political mandate to follow the high commands. They cannot express their own opinion publicly. So they have to follow the political high commands, and political high commands are not always consisting of homeopaths, and they cannot always express the proper views which can do good for homeopathy. And definitely the next point, which is the most important point, that political mandate is there to oppose the rival political parties, to establish their own existence. And exactly this is the point which I wanted to emphasize, that the unified platform must be apolitical. That platform must not have any relation with the political parties, because even if other political parties do good, this party, because of its own existence, because of this question of its own propaganda to the common people, they have to oppose the other political party. This is their political mandate. And most likely they have to be biased by their political views, and obviously the political party members get less time to devote for the cause of homeopathy, and definitely the service for the mankind and the homeopathy as well gets minimized. And now, before I start discussing on this side, I will tell you just two or three words. Well, you see that every organization, there are two kinds of organizations. One group is there who are the quantity lover. Who are the quantity lover? They love with the quantity and they compromise with the quality and doesn't care about fig about whoever comes there, whoever goes there, that doesn't matter. They just want to gather the number. This is on one hand. And certainly the other side is who are not compromising with the quality. Even they can compromise with the quantity and believe the truth lies with minority. But at the same time, there is another proverb also, the majority must be granted, especially in this democratic region. So a good organization must be a proper intermingling of these two. There must be the quantity where the quality should not be compromised. So the first one, that was a tussle of Dr. Ella Twentyman and Dr. J.N. Kanjilal in 29th International Homeopathic Congress, which was taking place at Washington. And there was a topic on symposium on homeopathic education. So the symposium on homeopathic education, while Dr. Twentyman was going to speak on this, and before I discuss about this discussion, may I introduce Dr. Twentyman to you first. Dr. Twentyman was a faculty from Royal London Homeopathic Hospital. Dr. J.N. Kanjilal opposed him and he said, if a principle is to be condemned as dogma, one has to prove that it is baseless or outmoded. Without doing that, if anybody calls it a dogma, it only depicts to say the least his mental rigidity, laziness, and optimism. That's old opposition. And happened after this opposition, I will tell you later on. And this is the voice of a preacher and a true lover of homeopathy, because this person was getting backed by the largest homeopathic organization of that day, which was the All India Institute of Homeopathic, AIHMA, All India Homeopathic Medical Association, AIHMA, All India Homeopathic Medical Association. I'm sorry, I was fumbling for that. Now, this is one example, what can happen with the quantitative faculty if there is compromising the quality. And now just coming to the second point, what happens with the political interference. This was in the late 70s, maybe I cannot exactly remember the year, but maybe it was 1978-79. The first Homeopathic Council of Sri Lanka was formed at that point of time, and he was nominated by Sri K.L. Senanayake. He was then Health Minister of Sri Lanka, and the council was formed under the chairmanship of Dr. C.V.S. Koria. But this was actually reconstituted later by the Health Minister because Dr. Koria was not a person who will move according to the date of Senanayake. So he removed him and he put somebody else according to his sweet will. And what happened finally, the entire organization got disrupted. Everything got ruined up, ending up in a mess. This is the largest global organization, LMHI, which was previously known as LIGA. On the left side, we can find the image of the American homeopath, Dr. Roy Upham, who was the founder of this organization. And this was actually founded in Rotterdam of Netherlands. And the physicians from Netherlands will be joining us in the later part of this seminar. This organization was formed in 10 September 1925 by 14 homeopaths and was constituted under the terms of Swiss civil law with Geneva designated as its own registered office. And nowadays, this organization has moved its office to the residence of Hahnemann at Germany. So this is the history of LMHI. And at that point of time, before 1974, which I was talking to you that I will tell you later on, before that time, LIGA was consisting of few Hahnemannian homeopaths like Dr. T.P. Pastero of Argentina and Dr. P.S. Ortega of Mexico. But unfortunately, they never dared to oppose the anti-Hahnemannian lobby because they were not backed up by any strong national organization. After 1974 battle by Dr. Kanjilal, an overwhelming majority was voted in favor of Hahnemannian principles. And in Athens Congress in 1976, the whole table of LMHI was turned in favor of the Hahnemannian principles, And that was heroically and effectively supported by those two doctors, Dr. Ortega and Dr. Pasteur. At that point of time, actually, the Western homeopaths believed that unless one is an allopathic graduate, he cannot be termed as a doctor. And only allopathic graduates who believed with the law of similia, they could become the full-fledged members of LMHI. Institutionally taught Indian homeopaths and holders of government recognitions from India, they were not entertained at all. After continuous struggle for more than one day, on 20th May 1979, Dr. Kanjilal was able to have Dr. Bholanath Chakraborty, all of you know his name, Dr. Bholanath Chakraborty, as the Assistant National Vice President of LIGA. And later on, Dr. Kanjilal admitted that he could win this battle single-handedly against 27 Western homeopaths only because he was backed by the resolutions from world's biggest national apolitical homeopathic organization, that is the HOMAI. So now you can easily get an idea that if an organization is filled with the allopaths who can only believe with the law of similia and even may not practice it properly, and even they have no courage to raise their voice against the anti-Hanumanian lobby, what kind of outcome from that organization can happen? The next slide, yes. So now this is the slide which shows about the world's largest national organization, that is the Homeopathic Medical Association of India. On left side, it is the photograph of the founder, president and president of honor of this organization, Dr. J.N. Kanjilal. And on the right side, it was AIIH, All India Institute of Homeopathy, and AIHMA, the organization that I have named just now. These two organizations were prevailing at that point of time, and they were the largest organizations in the India at that point of time. These two organizations started to converge, and they joined together in a convention which was named as the Convention of Homeopaths of India. It was taking place on 26th and 27th of October 1975 at Baligon Shikha Sadhan of Kolkata, and a single organization emerged out as the Homeopathic Medical Association of India. We may feel that what happens, whether these two organizations can emerge or not, just feel the AIIHMA and AIIH, these two organizations in their meeting held in Delhi on 19th December 1964, these organizations decided to forego its long cherished name and decided to merge with each other. Just think, they have decided to forego with their name, their fame and everything they have earned by their, actually these were hard earned. Any name in homeopathy is always hard earned. So we must learn the level of devotion of the organizers who could even forego their name, their entity and everything for the sake of greater cause of homeopathy. And only because of such kind of greatest devotion, HOMAI has emerged as world's biggest organization and still holding the biggest democratic platform for discussion on homeopathy. And now you have seen that the two organizations, HOMAI and IHK, has done good for the approach to PMO for COVID-19 infection. That they approached that homeopaths may be given an opportunity to make research and do all these things. And obviously, in India, we are having BHMS course, we are having degree courses and all these things. These are the contribution of HOMAI. And definitely, any constructive, all India-wise, I mean, national-wise homeopathic unified platform will be doing this good. Because this is an organization-based seminar, I would like to utter a few lines from the greatest organizers of India, and this is written here. It is only these menaces. What are the menaces? That is jealousy, selfishness, careerism, ambition for money, name, fame, all these things. These are actually, we search for these things. It is only these menaces that brings in the necessity of efficient leaders with qualities of unconditional sympathy and affection for all fellow beings belonging to same society or fraternity, with a sea of tolerance, with a sea of tolerance, patience and tactfulness, with unshakable zeal for the aims and objectives of the organization, completely free from any of these vices. this has been expressed by Dr. Jayan Kanjilan is one of his now with all these things. I hope I can make you understand why a unified common platform is required, which can only work for the development of homeopathy. And before I end, I repeat that we must remember one thing: united we stand, and divided we fall.